Welcome to tutorial video 5, Recording and Producing in Reason. In this tutorial, I will take you through each step in how to create the title music that you've heard at the beginning of each video so far. We'll be using the mixer and all the devices as well as the MIDI data in the sequencer window. Let's have a listen to the track. As you can see and hear in this track, in the main mixer we have the main fader and one of the instrument's devices faders highlighted in green. This means they are automated to undergo tasks by themselves when the music is playing. I have also used a combinator device here for mastering or adding effects. Then I have my Dr. Octo Rex loop player, which is also automated. I've used a Kong drum designer and changed some of the loops to be reversed or played backwards. You can see through this little button present in the drop-down menu. I then have a line mixer with two subtractor synthesizers, each playing the same notes but with different sound properties. It is very easy to change features within the track. Let's have a look at how to make it ourselves. To create this project, we first need to open a new project file in Reason. Now, depending on your preferences settings, I have my default song or new song to open as an empty rack. I then right-click in the blank space to create my devices. I'm going to go ahead and create all the devices I need straight away, starting with the mixer. By continuing the process of right-clicking, I can choose any of the devices that are listed in Reason 5. Just using the little tab arrows to hide it while I continue adding my other devices. Another important feature once you've added your devices to the Reason rack is to start naming them. Now, if you know the name of each device or instrument that you'll be adding before you compose, this is very handy. Each name on each device appears on its track in the mixer. And if we hit the tab key, we can see that each device has been automatically connected to the mixer. Now, if we go to the top and check our audio in, and that everything is set up properly, now we need to add the patches, or the sounds and settings for each device. In the combinator for mastering and effects, we're going to add the bass and drums setting. Let me just show you how to get there. We can browse through the orchestra or factory sound banks. We're going to use the factory sound bank and the M-Class mastering suite patches, bass and drums. Now, for the Dr. Octo Rex loop player, I used two main loops. By clicking the run button, we can hear it straight away. But I need to right click on the Dr. Octo Rex and initialize the patch. This wipes any existing settings. I can now use the browse patch button to find what I'm after. So once again, go to the Reason Factory Soundbank. We have our quick link on the left there. Drum loops. I'm going to use acoustic drums. Now let's try electronic. That sounds quite right. And that's going to be loaded into slot 1. Now I need to click on slot 2 to add the next loop. But if I click there, I'll get a problem. It's much easier and smarter to work using the drop-down menu and adding it in these little buttons here. So I'm going to click on number 2 here and click the Browse Loop or Patch button there. This way we'll add our second loop. Chemical Beats. And there we have it. Loop 1 and 2 are loaded. If we click the Run button, we can switch between both quite quickly. Now these three buttons here allow you to, as you press the Run button, switch between the two loops, either on the beat, on the bar, these are recorded as you run the loops through your composition. Now for the Kong Drum Designer. As soon as you add the Kong, it comes loaded with some patches. We're going to choose a generic drum pattern here. All we're going to do is choose a few of these sounds here, maybe the kick drum, and using the reverse button down the bottom, we can reverse it. Now that cymbal there sounds like it lasts a bit longer. And there's our click, as you've heard in so far the first 4 videos. Now, if you choose a cymbal that rings for too long and you reverse it, you end up having an attack that takes a while to be heard. Now, last of all, we have the Subtractor Synthesizer. Using the Browse Patch button, we can go to the Factory Sound Bank, Subtractor Patches, Bass, choose a nice bass pattern here, just maybe bass guitar. Now using my MIDI keyboard, I'm playing in some notes and you can hear them. And there's my bass pattern. Now, as you progress through each tutorial, it is important that you save your work. Here I'm going to save this as video music. And if you use Dropbox, that is a fantastic tool for you to save your work and have it backed up regularly. Right now, I'm going to put it in my home folder as a Reason song file. That is a template Reason file designated by .rns. Then we go up to the Window menu and detach the sequencer window. I'll just select the zoom tool there to zoom out our tracks. Now this toolbar at the top allows you to edit many of the features of the MIDI that is recorded in the MIDI sequencer window. You can access these tools using your QWERTY keyboard from QWERTY forwards and backwards. By clicking on a track, you arm it ready to record. Here we're going to undertake our first recording using the Dr. Octorex loop player. Make sure you have Enable Loop Playback and the Run button selected. Then in the sequencer window, we're going to check the click and pre-count in for when we press the record button. This gives us a click track to record to, as well as a one bar count in. We then go back to the Dr. Octo Rex Loop Player, right click on our sample buttons, and say Edit Automation. Now, as we press record and play the loops, our changes will be recorded. As you can see, the green lane in the sequencer window has recorded the change from loop 1 to loop 2. Now that was a little fast. By double-clicking in the tempo window, I can change the tempo to 100. Immediately, the change in tempo is noticeable. By clicking on the loop pattern itself, I can revert each of the loops to either pattern 1 or 2. I'm going to take off that click track. Now I want to adjust this loop to 8 bars, so I drag the right loop indicator and then just adjust the loop to the 8 bar mark. Up the top there you can see the snap bar is selected. I'm going to click the loop button down the bottom and here we go. And the pattern loops. Now we will record the other rhythm part using the Kong Drum Designer. I'm going to use my external MIDI Korg keyboard and the drum pads on it to test out the sounds I want to record. Once I've decided on the pattern I'm going to be using, I need to go over to the sequencer window. I'm going to make sure my click track is turned on, as well as my one bar count in. I'm going to double check that the track for the Kong drum is armed and ready to record, so that when I press record, it will record that instrument in that track. Now, not exactly a stellar performance. However, we can turn it into that. If we double click on this region here that was recorded, or click on edit mode, we can see the MIDI data that was recorded. On the left, I can audition each of the little sounds or samples. I can click and drag, copy paste, even lengthen the data there. Unclick edit mode and go back to song mode. I can do the same simply by double clicking. But what we're going to do is quantize it so that it plays in time. We need to go to Show Tool Window or F8. Then at the top we have our quantize settings. I'm going to set it to eighth notes or quavers at 100% and click apply. Now if we listen to it play back, it will all be in time. Going to take off the click track. Instant drum machine. In this part, we're going to be recording the bass line. I'll just turn that drum loop back to start at loop 1 and then loop 2. Now, going to the subtractor, I'm going to check that the MIDI keyboard and the mod wheels with it play the pitches through my mixer and headphones correctly. Then I'm going to go up to the window menu at the top here and say Show On-Screen Piano Keys. These are the notes I will be playing for this bass line. We're going to start with a low G, I'm going to move up a bit, and move up an octave to the next G above. Go back to G, C, D flat, C, and G. That's the main bass riff that I'll be using here. So the track is armed. Let's put on the click track and start recording. mod wheel on that note there. Now, once again, that recording needs a bit of quantizing. I'll play it back. It's not exactly in time. The use of the mod wheel slightly bent the timing. So I'm going to say show tool window, quantize again to eighth notes at 100%, apply, and let's have a listen to it now. Excellent, the timing is tight, the bass works well with the drum kits. Get a bit of compression to that bass. A few effects that are applied through the auxiliary sends in the mixer at the top here. Adjust some of the faders and do a quick rough mix just so that I can hear all three elements clearly. The bass seemed a little weak there. In the Baroque era, musicians would have the bass doubled with other instruments. So what we're going to do is right-click in the space beneath our original subtractor and add a line mixer. I'm going to rename it. And it's automatically routed to the top mixer and its name will appear in track 4 there. I'll then press the tab key and I'm going to unplug our original subtractor synth. That removes it from channel 3 in the top mixer. I'm then going to take the channel 4 lines and drag them to channel 3. Then, taking the out from our original subtractor, I'm going to put it into line 1 of our newly created line mixer. As you can see, our level is going through the line mixer into the main mixer. The second step is to click on the original subtractor and say copy devices and tracks. Right-click again and paste devices and tracks. We now have a duplicate copy of our bass data. Again, hit tab, take the cable out of the second subtractor into line 2, and we have two simultaneous bass lines. I can pan one to the right and the other to the left. Now let's change the sound properties of the second subtractor synth. I'm going to up the octave to 4 octaves and change the sound waves to square waves. I'll then adjust the resonance and the frequency filters over here. Let's have a listen. Already a very clear difference. We can experiment. We are now going to add an effect to our two bass lines. I'll right-click on the line mixer and add a Scream 4 distortion unit. By right-clicking on the line mixer, it automatically routes the Scream 4 distortion into the auxiliary sends for our bass line mixer. I can adjust the mix for each of the two basses. But I'm going to load a patch first. So we're going to tweak the bass lines here and let's add Iron Man. So I'm auditioning the whole mix here. As part of the final stages of this project, we're going to record some automation. I'm going to right-click on the main mixer fader and say Edit Automation. Now I want a fade out at the end of the loop. So I'll play through the samples, and towards the end of the track here, I'm going to drag the main fader down. As you can see, this movement is recorded and reflected in the sequencer window. I'll turn off the click track. And over here in the sequencer window, I have a new region. And the main fade out is now automated. Oh, but we have a problem. Towards the end of the track, it comes back up again. What I can do is go into edit mode. We'll double click on the blue region here. Then, choosing my pencil tool or using the W on our QWERTY keyboard, I can draw in more regions past the loop stage so that the main fader stays lowered. As you can see, it's graphically represented. And there we have it, a complete fade out using the main mixer's fader. The final stage of any of the compositions is to go to the file menu and export your composition as an audio file. This way it can be stored in your digital portfolio. That concludes the 5 introductory videos for Reason PBL Creations. I look forward to composing with you using the booklet resource.